if you're an old Roblox player, then you should know what happened through this day. But for those who don't know what happened, there was a time where Roblox got hacked, and this is the day, April 1st of 2012, 11 years later, and we'll talk about it now. It wasn't really hacked, it was compromised basically to these players. So what they did was, they were spamming Roblox and new announcements. They released some stuff that shouldn't have been released, and they were spamming inappropriate stuff on the Roblox forums. And that's all what happened. It wasn't a bad hack. It wasn't bad. It wasn't really bad at all. They were just trolling around. But one of them actually ruined the economy during that time. So it made me wonder, who is these three people that was involved in this? Well, the first person was LNA. So how he managed to get into the admin panels? Well, Roblox used to have these test websites where users were allowed to use them for like features and stuff. They're not there anymore. They're either locked, deleted, or like just unknown. So this guy got into the test site, made an account, took the Roblox security cookie on that site and tried to put it into the actual Roblox site, and he managed to do it, and that's how he became a Roblox administrator. That's how he became it. But it wasn't only him that was doing this. It was his two friends too. One was Collab244. He was the one who was responsible for, he actually compromised some Roblox staff members. A lot of rich popular Roblox players got the account compromised. Like people like undeveloped, the creator of Town of Roboxia, and Speedy, I don't know if I'm saying his name right. He got compromised too. They took his Dominus and then terminated him just to troll WoW and stuff. So yeah, Collab244 was the guy who was spamming inappropriate stuff. There's actually proof about it that it was him doing it, and Ellen Knight was the one who was spamming memes on like Roblox news announcement. There's this one face that was uploaded. I'm pretty sure people will forgot about it by now, but if you notice know, this, here's this face right now. It was just a meme face. So all I said, check. What about the third person? What did the third person do? But this guy right here, this guy is really the reason. This guy is the one who almost, I mean, he literally ruined the Roblox economy during this incident. His name is iTrap Isaac, if I should say. This guy, you won't believe me at all, but this guy is the creator of Brick Planet, the owner who made Brick Planet. And I was shocked when I heard about this. This guy is the one who really caused the most damage out of all three of them. Like, he's the one who's releasing all the items and stuff. He even sold some limitless, I believe, for some cheap prices and stuff. He was the one who took it too far. Like, he was way different than the other one, because he was the worst out of all of them. Even Ellen Knight was telling him that they had an argument, him and Isaac. Ellen Knight was telling Isaac that he was taking the whole situation way too far, way out of hand, and he was just messing with him. But he didn't care, he just continued doing it. This whole situation kept going to like an hour later, and Roblox finally got the chance to shut down the site. And then they made a blog post to talk about the whole situation. I'm gonna read their response right now. But here is the hashtag release. It was a crazy skull, a toxic nemesis, steampunk elephant, and Dino Bennett in the ice one. So here's the things. Here's their response.
After all this activity occurred, Roblox staff brought the site offline and reported that they were attempting to patch up the currency system. The website was brought back online during the late evening of April 1st. The site test admin panel was updated and the Roblox avatar shop was offline until the following evening. In a Roblox blog post on April 2nd, it was announced that Roblox experienced a site issue the evening of April 1st, and they took the site offline. They noted that several assets were released from the avatar shop backlog that were not ready for production, and several accounts were incorrectly granted large amounts of Robux. Some of these Robux were subsequently traded with other accounts. Some avatar shop and currency transactions were audited and rollbacked, and they estimated the rollbacks occurred in fewer than 0.01% of Roblox accounts. 2. Some items were updated with new pricing, while other items were taken off sale. The C. Face was changed to Dr. Smith Face and was temporarily available for purchase.
That's what basically happened. But you may wonder, what happened to the users? So, Elliot got terminated, and I said got terminated. But Collab244, he actually got away with it. He wasn't banned for that week, for that incident. He was, even though there was some proof of that, he wasn't banned from it. He basically got a free pass, so he was off the hook. Like, spread, like, free.